Grace and peace be multiplied to you through the knowledge of God and our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome. Today we'll be looking at Christ is God's link to man. Christ as God's link to man. God will have no fellowship with man outside of Christ. God needs a link to get to man. After man fell in the Garden of Eden, God needed a means by which he could use to reach man. And that means is just the very being of God himself in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. Adam linked man to Satan through the disobedience in the Garden of Eden by disobeying God. And Christ links man to God. And of course, every man is a function of who they are linked to. For those of us who are saved, we are partakers of divine nature because Christ has linked God to us. And when we use the word link, we mean in essence union. So Adam brought man in union with Satan. Christ has brought man in union with God. So Christ is God's union with man. Christ is God's link to man, which is the bane of the New Testament. Everything of the New Testament is sitting on that fact of union of God with man in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. Christ is the connection, the linking, is the connection linking God with man. Man was created to be a vessel that carries God. Man is created a container that carries God. Man was created in the image and the likeness of God so that God could walk on the surface of this earth. God could express himself on the earth through man. But of course, due to the fall of man, God needed a link, a connection between him, the God that dwells in unapproachable light, with fallen man. And that link is in the very person of the Lord Jesus Christ, who is the connection. A picture of this we can see of Christ being the link of God to man. We can see that in Genesis 28, 10 to 17, which is popularly referred to as Jacob's ladder, or the vision, the dream that Jacob had when he saw angels and descending upon from heaven to earth. And that link was a type of course, the reality we see in John 1, 51, that Christ is that link, the connecting point. A link is needed for God to reach man. Basic, God needs a link to reach man. Without a link, God cannot reach man. God is immortal, man is mortal. God is holy, man is unholy. God dwells in unapproachable light. God, man is dwelling in darkness. What fellowship with light have in darkness? A link is needed. And that link is just the very person of the Lord Jesus Christ. So Christ came to link God to man. So in incarnation, his purpose of coming was basically to link God to man. Man was living outside of God. Man was not living in the realm whereby God could actually dwell in him. God had created man to dwell in man. But because of the sin, the fallen nature of man, the transgression of the first Adam, God needed a link. So Christ came. That's why I said, I have come that they may have life and they have it abundantly. And that life is just the very being of God himself. So Christ came to link God to man. I could call that one of his key parts, one of the key mission of him coming to the, he said himself, I have come that I may do what? Link, in essence, in my own interpretation, I have come that they may have life, and the life is just God himself. So Christ came to link God to man. Christ is the link that dispenses God to man. So God wants to flow into man. Man is a vessel. Every vessel needs a content. It's the content that determines the value of any vessel. So God wants to flow into man. How would God flow into man? God has to use the link of Christ. So Christ is the link that dispenses God into man. It's actually the mystery of Christ is the content that God is dispensing into man. At the same time, it's also the link of that content. It's almost like saying that you get a water tanker and they're trying to bring water into a tank. The host and the water are two different things, essentially, as speaking in our natural sense. But in the mystery of Christ, is both the host and as well as the content. Is the content God is bringing into man, as well as the means which God is bringing that content, the way and as well as the life. So God wanting to come into us to be us needs a link. So God wanting to come into us to be us, God wants to be us. We were created to be God in life and nature, but not in his Godhead. God wants to come into every mortal human being, whether they are saved or they are not saved. But he cannot come into those who have not accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, because that's the medium, that's the means through which he's going to come into anyone. So everyone was created for God to come into them so that he could be the one living through them. So God needs a link to get that done, and that link is Christ. That's why we believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and we are saved. God became flesh to be linked to man. So God manifested in the flesh. God, the God that manifested in the flesh, is just the very being of Christ. So God, so you can see the processes, because it wasn't an easy process. When God created man in Genesis 1 on the sixth day, he spoke. I mean, he went to the dust of the earth, and under a day it was done. But for him to now, after man had fallen, for him to now redeem man, to now live in man, that took years and years. So part of that process, he had to go through a process himself. First, he had to become a man in himself. So it wasn't something external of him. He didn't have, he couldn't go back to the dust of the earth, because the dust of the earth would do him no good. He had to just become the second man in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. So he became flesh in order to be linked to man. God would have no dealing with man without a link. There's just no way about it. God is not going to have any kind of fellowship, God is not going to have any kind of relationship with man without a link. God needs a link, and that link is just the person of Christ. A link essentially could be said as a connecting point of point A and point B. A link could be said also to mean that it's the medium through which point A gets to point B, or point B gets to, it's a means of communication, a means of interaction, like a currency, a medium of exchange. So God will have no lead dealing with man without a link. Christ is the way, Christ is the link, Christ is the means of everything God will do with man. God needs a link to man. Man as well needs a link to God. So first, God needs to reach man. A man as well needs to reach God, because man was created for God. Man was created to carry God. I mean, is man, every man is going to feel a sense of, when I mean man, woman, we're speaking not gender-wise, but God created every one of us. We are children of God, as saints of God in Christ Jesus. So everyone, every man created needs, there's a dissatisfaction in the heart of every man. And that dissatisfaction is only fulfilled in God. It's only God that can fill that vacuum that is in every man. So man needs a link to God, needs a link to man. Man needs a link to God. And mysteriously, Christ is both God's link to man and man's link to God. So it's just one link. It's just one way. There's no other means to God. And there's no other means for man to God and for God to man. There will never be any other means. Salvation is in no other name than in the person of Christ. So it's both God's link to man and man's link to God. So it brings God to man as the temple of God, as the tabernacle of God. It now brings man to God as offering that man presents to God. So it brings God to man and also brings man to God. What a joy to this great mysterious link in the person of Christ. God has linked himself to man in Christ Jesus. God has linked himself to man in Christ Jesus. This is a profound statement. This is actually the gospel. This is the gospel. The gospel is that God has linked himself to man in Christ Jesus. In the person of Christ Jesus, God became flesh. God became flesh so as to pass through the process of human living, crucifixion, and resurrection in order to eventually become one with man. That is the gospel. That is the gospel in, in a big picture. So God has linked himself to man in the person of Christ Jesus. This is why God is drawing, the Father is always, John says, drawing people to Christ. God is bringing people to Christ, because God, Christ is in God, God is in Christ. So as the Father is drawing people to Christ, what is happening is that God is saying that you can only be linked with me by being linked with Christ. So Christ is the very link that links man and God together. So God has linked himself to man in Christ Jesus. What a joy. God linking himself to man is God mingling himself with man. Mingling is a deep form of union, a very deep form of union. So God linking himself to man, essentially what God is saying is like, I want to become one with man. Of course, and in this one I'm going to become with man is in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is not outside of Christ. God does not become one with any man outside of Christ. It is only in Christ Jesus that God becomes one with man, which was part of the prayer of the Lord in John 17, that they may be one in us. What a joy that God is now mingled with us in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. God linking himself to man is God becoming one spirit with man. He that is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him. 1 Corinthians 6:17. So by linking himself to man, essentially God doesn't want to be a remote God to man. God is no longer remote to us who are the saints in the New Testament, the new creation, the children of God. God is not remote to his children. God doesn't want to be a distant God. God is no absentee father to us in the New Testament. God has linked himself to us and has become one spirit with us in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. The New Testament is God linking himself to man. If we want to put it in that order, basically in the Old Testament, God could not link himself organically to man. Only Israel had that because they were just a shadow of the church, a type of the church, temporary measure, the blood of goats, because the price had not been paid. So organically, God linked himself to man in the New Testament. So we cross over to the New Testament, and here we see the incarnation of Christ. God is manifested in the flesh. The Word has become flesh. Jesus, Jehovah, our Savior, the Word has become flesh and tabernacled among us. What a joy. Christ is God's link to flow into man. So like we said earlier, God wants to flow into man. So Christ is a lot of things to us in the body of Christ so that God can flow into us. So he's the very link God uses to flow, to dispense himself, to minister himself into us as the redeemed. God has linked himself to man through Christ. So God has linked himself to man through the very person of the Lord Jesus Christ. Is the means through which God has linked himself to us. There will be no other means. There is no other means. There was never any other means that God used to link himself to man outside of Christ. And what a joy that the last Adam today, who has become the life-giving spirit, is the very means God is linking himself to us. So there are many things the Lord Jesus Christ, we are told in the scriptures, that the Lord Jesus Christ acts. We don't see the word link in the Bible. I don't think you just see the word. But the fact is there. Linking, like I mentioned earlier, is basically a form of union. That is God reaching man. A link is needed for a person to reach another person, or for point A to point B. So Christ is a lot of things in order for God to be linked to man. One of those things is we look at Christ is the living water for God to flow into man. So we see a lot of things that we are told in scripture that Christ is the living water, is the living bread, is the living word, is the author of life, is a lot of things so that God could reach man. So a lot of the titles, the offices that the Lord Jesus Christ occupies is because God wants to reach man. Christ is the Lamb of God for God to reach man. So Christ is the living water. He said, those who believe in him, whoever thirsts should come to him. For those who drink out of him, out of their belly will flow rivers of living water. So that God can flow into man. Christ is also the way for Christ as the way is God's channel to reach man. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. So Christ is the way, is the means, is the route which God has used to reach man. There is no other way God uses to reach man. And this is not just in our initial salvation experience. Every day we need Christ as the way. So it's not just because, oh, we are saved, we are children of God, so that's it for us. We know, yes, we've been saved, but that's just initial. Every day, Christ is the way out of any situation. Christ is the way from us in the point where we are spiritually to go to the next level in God. Christ is the way to get in there. Christ is the way for us to fulfill our destiny. Christ is the way in our parenting. Christ should be the way in our vocation. So with the lot of things for ministry fulfillment, Christ is the way for anything we do. So it's God's channel to reach man. What a joy. Also, Christ as the light is God's link to get man out of darkness. That there's no other, the only solution darkness respects is light. Christ is the light that darkness cannot comprehend. So God wants to get man out of the region of death, out of the pit of darkness. And Christ is the very light, the great light that has appeared to those that sat in darkness. So those of us that sat in darkness when we were in Adam, Christ is the light God has used to link himself to us, to bring us out of darkness and bring us into his marvelous light. Christ as God and man is links divinity with humanity. That's the mystery of the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. He's God and he's man. So he's God. In some contexts we call him the God man, Jehovah our Savior. He became flesh, the Word becoming flesh in incarnation, and also he now became a life-giving spirit in resurrection. He has brought divinity, he has made divinity mingled with humanity. He has made God approachable to man. He has made God meetable, knowable to man. What a joy to the person of Christ. Christ as the Word. Again, we're at this point we're looking at the things that Christ is, or the person, the title that Christ carries, that is actually buttressing the fact that he's linking God to man. Christ as the Word is God's linking himself to man by speaking. Words that we speak carry energy. Words are not just mere words. Man was created to be a life-speaking spirit like God. Our words carry energy. And when God wants to transmit himself into us, he speaks to any man. He said, the words that are spoken to you, they are spirit and they are life. Words carry life and they carry death. He said, death and life are in the power of the tongue. So we can see that what God is saying is that when God is speaking to us, he's actually transmitting himself, he's dispensing himself into us. This is why he said we should keep hearing the word of God. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. He said, in the beginning was the word was with God, and the word was God. So Christ is the word of God, so that God can link himself to man by speaking. What a joy, what a joy to the person of Christ. Christ is also the ladder, like we mentioned earlier in that Genesis 28, 10 to 17, in the vision of Jacob, which the Lord repeated in John 1, 51, that you see the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. So we can say, I could even read that quickly, John chapter 1, verse 51, that Christ is the very means through which God is linking himself to man. God will have no fellowship with man outside of Christ. Outside of Christ, no man has any hope of coming in communion with God. John chapter 1 verse 51, the Lord Jesus Christ said, and he said to me, verily I say unto you, hereafter you shall see heaven open and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. So is the ladder connecting heaven to earth and earth to heaven as well. What a joy to the very person of Christ. Christ as bread of life is also man linking with God by eating. So God created, I won't say created, Christ is, like I mentioned, Christ is many things, so that God can link himself to us. We said that Christ is the living word, so that God can link himself to man by speaking. Christ is the bread of life, so that God can link himself to man partaking of God in eating, because God wants man to eat him. He said, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. He said that man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. He said, my flesh is true food and my blood is true drink. Ezekiel 2:2. He said, take my word, eat it. So God wants us to eat him. And in eating God, actually God dispenses himself into us by eating of his word. By eating of God, God is able to link himself into us. Whatever you eat releases its nutrient into you. Whatever type of food or fruit you eat, it's going to release its nutrient into you. So Christ as bread of life is for God to link himself to man. Christ is the living water. We looked at that earlier, so that God can link himself to man. Christ is the light through which God is able to link himself to man, to bring man out of darkness. Christ is God's link of saving man. There is no other means God uses to save any man. Again, this saving is not just the initial salvation. Sometimes our dictionary in our brain thinks that, oh, okay, we've been saved already, so okay, we know Christ. But this saving is needed. Hebrews 7:25, he said he's able to save us to the uttermost. We need to be saved every day. I don't mean the initial salvation. We need to be saved from anger. We need to be saved from the powers of darkness in terms of the wickedness that is in this world. It's sufficient that the evil of every day. We need to be saved from a lot of things, a lot of schemes, traps, wiles of the devil. So this saving is not just one means. Christ is God's link daily for saving us from any situation. We need to be saved from prayerlessness. We need to be saved from the spirit of jealousy. We need to be saved from the spirit of laziness. So many things that we need to be saved from, and God is patient. So his spirit is in us to get us saved through the Lord Jesus Christ. So Christ is God's means of saving man, initially from the kingdom of darkness to his own kingdom, and now to save us from the old nature, the Adamic nature, so that the new creation life will be made manifest in our life. Christ is God's link of dwelling in man. So God wants to dwell in man. That's part of the reason I believe he created man in his image and likeness, but he needs a link to be able to dwell in man. He can't dwell in man because man was in the region of death. Man was in Adam through the sin of Adam. But now, any man that accepts the Lord Jesus Christ, God is able to make his home in that vessel. And that vessel is only possible because they've accepted the Lord Jesus. John 14:23, the Lord has said that those who love him and keep his word, he and the Father will make their home in him. Christ is man's link of receiving God's life. So there are many things God wants to give to man. So, for example, in whatever part of the world you are, maybe for those in US, you find you want to buy certain things on Amazon or in any part of the world, of course you go buy it and they're going to ship it. You whatever you've bought, there's a means to get it in there to your to the address you want it shipped to, right? So God wants to give a lot of things to man, and what's the medium, what's the courier is going to use is just Christ. Man as well needs a lot of things from God. What's the medium through which man will be able to let God know in this situation? It is just Christ. So Christ is man's link of receiving God's life. That is the means God gives man his life. Christ is also man's link of fellowshipping with God. God, we have no fellowship with man without Christ. And by the mercy of God, by the mercy of God again, we'll probably do another video teaching as the Lord wills on Christ as our fellowship with God. Christ as our fellowship with God. So Christ is man's link of fellowshipping with God. What a joy, what a joy. Christ is also man's link of receiving God's Spirit. God wants to give his Spirit to man. Yes, he wants to. That's why he gave man a spirit, so that the Spirit of God and the human spirit of man could be mingled as one, and which became a reality in the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, that he that is joined to the Lord is one spirit with him. Also, Christ is man's link of receiving God's life, which we looked at earlier on. The divine life of God comes into us, comes into any mortal man by the link of Christ. Christ is the very means. He said, I have come that they may have life. He said, Christ, who is our life. So that is the means through which we receive the life of God. Christ, for there is no, this second, 1 Timothy chapter 2 from verse 4, 5, 6, for there is one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus, who was the ransom. And let me even read that, 1 Timothy chapter 2. It's always good. We use that a lot in the place of intercession for 1 Timothy, that's therefore that we pray for all men, especially those in authority. Let me read from from 1 Timothy chapter 2. I'll read from verse 4. Who we have all men to be saved. Remember from verse 3, for this is good and acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. For there is one God, verse 5, for there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself a ransom for all to be testified in due season. So that's the medium, that is the only link man has with to God. That's the way to God. There's no other way to God. No other prophet, in terms of like the Muslims believe, like sometimes the pagans believe as well. There's only one channel to God. It is the person of Christ. Everyone, that whether we are pastors, prophets, apostles, if it is not Christ we are pointing the people to, it's almost like we are trying to create another religion in our own sense. Every one of them, we are vessels pointing to Christ, that Christ is the only way to God. What a joy. We are alive to God through the link of Christ. Romans chapter 6, I think verse 11, that we are alive unto God through Christ Jesus. So our being alive, we were dead in Adam, but God has quickened our spirit man and is now alive to God. And by that, it means that in every second, whether we are asleep or awake, God is ever alive to us. I remember maybe growing up, and usually sometimes there could be power failure, sometimes you have electricity, sometimes you don't have electricity, but all of a sudden maybe you get into some part of the world and you find that the electricity is just there, whether at night or in daytime. So there's no power outage in God with any of his children. He's ever alive to us. That's part of the reason for the New Testament. If there's any power outage, the fault is from us. From us, the enemy is more than likely condemning and trying to maybe darken, so as that fellowship will not exist. But of course, through the word of God and through the Spirit of God, we remain in fellowship with God. We are sons of God through the link of Christ. So we are. So the identity we have, almost every identity that we have in the new creation, is because of our link with Christ to God. So we are sons of God because we are linked to Christ. It's simple as that. Someone is an American because they were born in America, or maybe they got married to America. Even in your land, in whatever nation you're watching from, it's probably their citizenship by birth, their citizenship by marriage, and whatever. So our identity as sons of God is because of our link to Christ. So everything we see in the new creation, whether the righteousness of God, the ambassadors of God, is because of our link with Christ. The gospel is Christ linking God to man. So the gospel is Christ linking God to man. That is the good news we are to take to the world. That is the good news we are telling the unbelievers, the sinners, that God wants to link himself to you. Let's for a second leave the pact that where would they go when they die? Many of them know that their doom is waiting for them. They know. Some of them know, some of them don't know. But a better way I think we can present the gospel is that God wants to link himself to man. No one in their right senses will reject an offer from God to be linked to them, because they know their powers can do them no good on the swelling, the day of the swelling of Jordan. So the gospel, the good news is Christ is linking God to man. He has come to link God to man. We are faultless before God through the link of Christ, without fault, irreproachable in the eyes of God because of our link with Christ. Ephesians 1 chapter 4, especially look at the good news that God before the found, he predestined us before the foundation of the world so that we could be in union with Christ, so that we could be faultless and holy before him in love. This was his good pleasure. He has called us and made us one with himself through our union with Christ. So we are faultless before God through our link with Christ. Everything God is to us is because of our link with Christ. So whatever thing we can think that God is to us in the church, in the New Testament, as a new creation of God, is because of our link with Christ. God is our Father. Why is God our Father? God is our Father because of our link with Christ. If we are not linked with Christ, God can never be our Father. God will just be a creator to us, just like he's a creator of monkeys and all the other animals. But we are a step farther than the other creatures of God because we are linked with Christ. God is our Father because of our link with Christ. So we don't lose sight of that. When we are calling in Abba Father, we are saying that fatherhood means impartation of life, transference of life, that God has transferred his life into us because of our link with him. Every father biologically has their gene in their children. So God has transmitted his life into us because of our link with Christ. And that's why we are called the sons of God. God is our refuge because of our link with Christ. God is our refuge because of our link with Christ. We should never forget this. God is our abode. God is our high tower. God is our secret place because of our link with Christ. Outside of Christ, no man dare say that God is his refuge. No man dare say that he's taking refuge under God, because where will light and darkness mingle? So this is why, one of the reasons why we give thanks to God, to appreciate him for what he has done for us in Christ Jesus. What a joy. God is our abode because of our link with Christ. It's our abode. That is our place where we live. And you can say a refuge might be needed in terms of war, troubled times and what have you. And abode is a place of satisfaction. You could almost say, essentially you could say they are the same thing, but you can also look at it from another different aspect. Now look, we are dwelling in God. We are abiding in God, our eternal abode. Whether we are going to work, whether we are at home, wherever we are, whether we are asleep, we are in Christ. He said that in Colossians 3. He said he has hidden your life is hidden with Christ in God. So God is our abode because of our link with Christ. Without the link of Christ, God cannot save man. There is no way for God to save man without this link. There's no salvation in any other name than in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Without the link of Christ, God cannot dwell in man. God will not dwell in man without the link of Christ. So when we look at this, it just, for me, it praises and thanksgiving and adoration is just springing forth from my heart, appreciating the Lord for, thank you for you are the connecting link of God to me. I need a connection from me to God every day, not just at initial salvation. Every moment I need God in my life, and I believe every human on the surface earth, our greatest need as human is just God. The greatest shortage, incidentally, not from the side of God, the greatest abundance that is available to man is God. The greatest shortage of man is God, in terms of man not accepting the fact that is insufficient in itself. God is ever available. God is everywhere, ever ready to fill any man with a spirit that calls upon him. He said he's rich to all those that call upon him. Without the link of Christ, man cannot dwell in God. So God cannot dwell in man. Also, man cannot dwell in God without the link of Christ, because 1 John 4:15 says that whoever confesses that Jesus is Lord, God dwells in him and he in God. So God is abiding in us, and we are abiding in God because of the very person of Christ, the link of Christ. So we see some preposition in the New Testament that accentuates and buttress the fact that God has linked himself to us. So when we say things like in, the prepositions in, by, through, because, all every of these link onto, they all point to that fact that God has linked himself to us, like by Christ, in Christ, through Christ, because of Christ. And it's just essentially the scriptures is telling us, the Holy Spirit is telling us that look, you are linked to God through through the very person of Christ, that Christ has become our righteousness because of God. Christ has become our righteousness because we are linked with Him. It's not the righteousness of anyone that is not linked to Him. So we are acceptable before God because of our link with Christ. We are sons of God because of our link with Christ. What a joy for what the Lord has done. We are God's habitation because of our link with Christ. God's habitation. We are God's house because of our link with Christ. The habitation of God. We have the address of God on the surface of the earth. That's the truth. God is making His home in our heart. So we are the dwelling place of God. So wherever we go, we bring the very presence of God into that atmosphere, into that environment. That's why God has redeemed us to be a light in every field of human endeavor. So God is our habitation because of our link with Christ, and we are God's habitation as well because of our link with Christ. We have been baptized into the Trinity because of our link with Christ. It's a privilege, great privilege, if not one of the greatest privilege under heaven, for a mortal man to be immersed into the divine Trinity. Wow, to be overshadowed with the divine Trinity, to be saturated, to be soaked with the divine Trinity, it's a great privilege. And this is courtesy of our link with Christ. We could never be baptized into the divine Trinity without being linked with Christ. What a joy for what the Lord. So our link with God is Christ. So let that be our song. Let that be our praises, our worship to God, that thank you for the link of Christ. Thank you that we can pray to you in the name of Christ because it's our link. Thank you, Lord, that you forgive our sins because of our link with Christ. Thank you, Lord, that you accept our praises because of our link with you. Thank you that our offerings are acceptable to you because of our link with your dear son. What a joy. God's only link to us is Christ Jesus. There is no other link God uses to deal with us. He is God's currency of dealing, of relating with man, is God's channel of relating with man. God has no other channel by which He will use to relate with any man outside of Christ Jesus. So we appreciate God for this great gift He has given to us, for this great medium, and this medium is just the very being of God Himself. So God has given Himself to us in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. What a joy to the link of Christ in our life. That's why the Lord said, I am the way. I am the way. The name means that I'm not one of the ways. I am the way, the authentic way, the truth, the reality of God, and the life, the experience of God. So He is the way to God, He is the reality of God, He is the experience of God. Everything of God points back to the person of Christ. The wisdom of God is Christ, the power of God is Christ, the love of God is Christ, the glory of God is Christ. Mention the mercy of God, mention anything of God, it is in the person, the reality is in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why He is the link of God to man. He's also man's only link to God, man's only hope spending eternity with God is in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, no one comes to the Father except by me. No one comes to the Father. There is no other way to the Father outside of me. The Lord Jesus Christ is saying from that John 14:6 that there is no other means that any man will get to the Father except through the very person of the Lord Jesus. This is why we are rejoicing. We are full of thanksgiving. We are full of praises to God for what He has done for us in Christ Jesus. So today we've been able to look at the topic, Christ is God's link to man. We said a link is needed because God needed to save man. God wants to reach man, but a link is needed for Him to reach man. How will God reach man? First, our first parent linked us to Satan. Adam linked us to Satan. Christ links God to us. Christ links God to us and also links man to God. What a joy for what the Lord Jesus Christ has done. God needs a link to do a lot of things in the life of man. God wants to get into the very heart of man to make man His habitation, to make man His abode. But how will God get into man? He needs a link. The link is just the very person of the Lord Jesus Christ. God became flesh in order to be linked with man. God became a life-giving spirit in order to be linked to man. God also came in the form of the world became flesh and tabernacled among us so that He could be very much linked to man. Without a link, we could have no fellowship with God. Without a link, we dare not say we are sons of God. Without the link of Christ, we dare not say we are the temple of God. Without the link of Christ, we dare not say God is our refuge. God is a lot of things to us because of the link of Christ. Christ is a lot of things to us as well because of our link with Him. Christ is the living bread, so that man can be linked to God by eating. Christ is the living word, so that man can be linked to God by hearing the word of God, meditating on the word of God, eating the word of God, feeding on the word of God. Christ is the light, so that God could link Himself to man as light and bring man out of darkness. So Christ is a lot of things to us. God is a lot of things to us because of our link with Christ. So every day, our rejoicing, our thanksgiving is always to God that He is the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by Him. What a joy that we have the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior, as our Redeemer, as our life, as our refuge. Hallelujah to the Heavenly Father. Hallelujah to the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah to the Eternal Spirit. Praise the Lord. Christ as God's link to man. Hallelujah.